Managing your business contacts and marketing campaigns is hard, and you will probably end up using more than one plugin or platform. So it's no surprise you're gonna need to transfer data to and from FluentCRM. Now the plugin integrates with a lot of plugins and platforms. But what if you need to exchange data between platforms without direct integration? The solution is WebHooks. This video is going to show you how you can use WebHooks to exchange data between FluentCRM and external platforms, and once you're done, your data will be flowing through FluentCRM smoothly. Let's say you're collecting leads on another website via FluentForms and want to bring your contacts to the one that has FluentCRM installed in it. For this, we'll be using incoming webhook feature. From the FluentCRM dashboard, go to Settings. From here, let's create a new incoming webhook. Name the webhook, choose the lists and tags you want to attach to the contacts. And choose the status of the contacts you want to add. There! You now have the URL you are gonna need to set it up with FluentForms, which is installed in your other website. So let's head over to the FluentForms dashboard. It'll work for any website that is webhook friendly. So again, go to Settings. You should see the webhook option here. If you don't, simply go to Integrations and enable webhooks. Now we can add a new webhook. Name it, paste the request URL from FluentCRM. We'll select post and JSON, click save. Now let's test it out. Fill up the form. Ours is a simple form with just a name and email ID because we wanted to keep it simple for the demo. Hit submit, is it working? Let's find out from FluentCRM contacts. And here it is. So what if you want to use your valuable FluentCRM data in a third-party platform? Well, for that, we're going to use Zapier. You can connect and transfer data from any existing automation, but for this course, we're gonna make a new one. So let's create a new automation. Let's name the automation. Then we are going to set a trigger. Pick any that works for you. Next, we add the outgoing webhook action block. Now you will see the input field for remote URL. We're gonna grab the URL from Zapier. If you don't have a Zapier account, no problem. Signing up takes a couple of minutes at max. Once that's sorted, we'll create Zap. As a trigger, we'll set webhook and choose catch hook for action. Now click continue to get the URL. We're gonna copy this and paste it in the remote URL box of FluentCRM. We're not done yet, let's set up a few more things. Do you want your entire user data or do you want to transfer certain parts of it? In the request body option, you can choose to either load full subscribers data or select custom data if that's not what you want. There's a lot more you can do, for example, use the request header option to get additional data, but these are not mandatory options for data transfer, so let's skip this for now. Let's save settings and set the automation as published. Now we can test it out. Let's manually add a contact from the FluentCRM dashboard. Then we will choose add to automation and choose the automation funnel we have connected to Zapier. Click here to add the contact to the automation. We can now go back to Zapier to test trigger, and yep, it's working. Now that they're connected, we can move on to action. In this video, we will export our FluentCRM data to Google Sheets. You can select whatever works for you from the dropdown. We already have a sheet we want our data in. If you don't have one yet, create a new worksheet and select it from here. Now, let's access the Google Sheet. And there you have it. All your FluentCRM data jotted down in the Google Sheet you wanted. And as we promised at the starting of this video, you can now seamlessly transfer data to and from FluentCRM. Connect to any third party, make the most of your data, and in the process, boost productivity and role. Until next time, stay tuned to WPManageNinja.